Hi, and welcome to Kanika's Nursing Academy. I'm Kanika, and today we'll be continuing our ECG classes where we left from the last class. And just to give you an overview of what we have discussed till now in ECG interpretation is, first of all, we had discussed about the cardiac conduction system, and this is just to make all of you revise that what we have done in this cardiac conduction system. The natural pacemaker of the heart, which is the SA node or the sinoatrial node located at the upper chamber, that is the right atrium, it initiates the electrical impulse, and the impulse travels towards the AV node, which is located at the junction of the atrium and the ventricle, and then it moves towards the bundle of His, which is in the septum, and the terminal end of the bundle of His are the Purkinje fibers. And when it reaches the Purkinje fibers, ventricular contraction occurs. When it starts from the SA node and goes towards the AV node, the atrial contraction occurs, and the whole cardiac conduction system will be seen as a cardiac cycle, and the recording of this cardiac cycle or the electrical activity of the heart is known as electrocardiography. So, मैंने अपनी क्लास में लास्ट में बताया था स्टूडेंट्स के लिए कि there is a basic interpretation of ECG which is very helpful for the students to understand the concept of ECG and how it is to be seen when the patients are coming for the ECG and you are taking the ECG for the patient. So these are the steps which we have been discussing in the last classes. There are 5 steps for the students to understand about the basic interpretation of ECG. Step number 1 was the calculation of heart rate, and we have completed this portion. And heart rate calculation, I have told you about the 6-second method and how the QRS complexes are to be calculated, and they have to be multiplied by 10, and the heart rate will be coming in the multiples of 10. And there are other methods like 300 square method and 1500 method. Then we have seen regarding the heart rhythm as well. The rhythm of the heart can be either regular or irregular, and in terms of regularity and irregularity, we have to see both the atrial rhythm as well as the ventricular rhythm, whether the atrial contraction and the ventricular contraction is taking place in a synchronized manner. So that will be seen in the regular or the irregular pattern. And further regarding the regularity and the irregularity will be discussed in the classes of the dysrhythmias or the abnormal ECGs. Now today, the main points to be discussed in today's class will include the interpretation regarding the P wave, the PR interval, and the QRS complex. So just to give you an overview, that these were the steps: heart rate, rhythm, P wave, PR interval, and QRS complex. And we have completed heart rate, we have seen the rhythm also. Now coming to the interpretation about the P wave, and as I have explained, that when the SA node initiates the electrical impulse, and this is the time when there is automaticity taking place, and at the same time the impulse is going to travel towards the AV node, and that is the time when the atrial contraction is occurring. And on an ECG strip, the atrial contraction is manifested as P wave. This is how the P wave is, and this is manifested as the atrial contraction or the P wave. So there are basically 5 questions which we need to answer while seeing the P wave on the ECG. First question says, are the P waves present? And if they are present, that means SA node is functional. And if the P waves are not there, or if they are replaced by some other malformed waves, then that means there is some abnormality in the conduction by the SA node. Then second question is, are the P waves occurring regularly? Again, the question is about the regularity and the irregularity. So in a normal ECG, the P waves versus QRS ratio is always 1:1. That means after every atrial contraction, one ventricular contraction has to take place. So they have to be regular in their appearance. Third question is there a P wave for each QRS? Means there has to be one atrial contraction followed by the QRS complex, that is the ventricular contraction. So there has to be a ratio of 1:1, which means this is a normal ECG. Then the characteristics of P waves, which is very important to note down, that are the P waves smooth, smooth, rounded and upright in position, or are they inverted? This is a question to be asked. They have to be smooth and rounded and upright in position, and if they are coming out to be inverted, it means there is a premature complex taking place. And because we are talking of the atrial contraction or the P wave, the inverted P wave would mean that the premature atrial complexes are being made. Fifth question about the P waves is, do all the P waves look similar? Which means that across the ECG there would be so many P waves followed by the QRS complexes. So all the P waves have to look similar, which will reveal that the patient is not having any dysrhythmic condition, there is no arrhythmia, and the patient is having a normal cardiac cycle taking place. So this was about the question number 3, that is interpretation of P wave in the ECG, and in the next class you can see about the interpretation of PR interval. Thank you.